Well, you probably know him best as an international soccer star, but there's a side to former Socceroo Tim Cahill that you may not be aware of, and he joins me in the studio today. Tim, thank you so much for joining us. Now, you're actually a very successful children's author. Your 10th book in the Tiny Timmy series is released this month. Can you take us a bit through the concept of what these books are about?
Yeah, definitely. I think they're pretty much life lessons throughout my whole career. In layman's terms, you know, I did a biography, but for kids, in layman's terms, they're lessons that I've learned throughout my journey over the 23 years as a professional. Being told that I wasn't big enough, never going to make it, being the new kid, going to a World Cup, now with a new coach, stuff like that. So it's about connecting with the kids, the inclusion of girls, my daughter's in it, my kids are involved in it. And it's something that 2015 November started, yep, and still on this journey now, really, to, you know, it's great for education and also good to give something back.
Yeah, it sure is. I mean, you're a successful sportsman. I guess what triggered that? Oh, let's write a children's book. Was it your own kids?
No, well, you know, I've been involved in grassroots for many years, over a decade in Australia, free grassroots programs. You know, with Weet-Bix for 14 years, healthy eating. I do breakfast clubs. And now, knowing that I was transitioning into retirement now, 39 years old, afterwards, keeping to relay the message. And through these books and, you know, being with so many children around the world, I was just in Lebanon for the schools project that we're doing with FIFA. I think it's just a nice way to interact with them, but also just to give the clear messages and understand that to give kids hope and to also, you know, be educational in a different way.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's so much technology around. How important do you think it is for kids to actually read a physical book?
Well, for me, it's about the interaction. You know, parents reach out to me, their kids with dyslexia, things like that. Even if the kid opens it and colours in the pages. And you've got to have relating stories to children about a group and how important it is to have friends and also to be included, you know. Around the world, you know, you've got so many different multiculturalisms, people in Australia and around the world. And I think for me, bringing that together, I did Where's Timmy, different countries, finding my football, finding this. It's something that I think about, and also in the future, just to be creative and not the one dimensional footballer that played for so long.
Yeah, we've got four kids. What do they think of Dad's books?
Now, the kids are so influential because my daughter Sienna, when I did the me and her together in the book, the importance of the girls doing so well in sport and supporting that side of it as well. Cruzy, my seven-year-old, he always has an input. And obviously my boys are older now and they're proud because I can include them in the book, yep, also their friends and also, you know, kids that I meet on my journey throughout my career.
You've written 10 books. Is there another 10 to come?
There'll be quite a few coming. There actually will be quite a few coming, but I'm looking on going international. I'm in six countries in the world. I'm in every single school in Australia. And this week I'll be on the 19th in Penrith, a big W, to do an appearance, to sign some book for some kids and, you know, just enjoy the experience and coming back to Australia to have some interactions.
You're an absolute inspiration to so many children and adults alike. It's been great to have you today. And I know this 10th instalment will be a big success. I can't wait to take it home for my kids to read it tonight. Tim, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for your support. Thank you very much.